Hello friends, welcome back to this series of React.js, and in today's video we are going to discuss about how to deal with the states of a class component. In the last video we have seen that how we can create a class component which can be rendered inside the index.js like this. You have provided the properties like name and age, and this was printed, this was rendered on the main page, the index.html, when it is executed. So this was the thing which was happening. So today we are going to deal with the states. States are basically used for the dynamic component rendering. So how it is dynamically changed when the state of a object changes over the time period, or when the properties, certain properties of an object changes over the time period during the course of the execution of your application, how that is managed, for that you must need to understand first about the states. So today we are going to understand what is state and what we need to do to maintain the state. So inside the student class we have this thing like you have to pass it outside the class. You are passing this thing from outside the class, right? The name and the age, you are passing it outside the class, and it is always dependent on the values which is coming from outside the class. But sometimes you must need to maintain the state of an object which you are going to render, or you can say the state of a component which you are going to render on your web page. Okay, so for that we need to have the properties of this class, just like you have the properties of the classes in your other programming languages, like you might have seen in the C# classes or in Java classes. Similarly here, to maintain those properties we use the state. So how to define the state? We need to just write like this: state is equal to this curly braces. And then you can just simply write like first property will be the name, and you can write something like this .props.name. Okay, so whatever you are passing from here, index.js, in the name, that will come to the props inside the props object and with the property name, right? So whatever it is coming in the name, I am putting it in the name state, in the state for this name property, right? And now we are going to add the age in the same manner, and you need to use this colon, not the equal sign, this dot props dot age, and that's it. And here when you will print it, it will be displayed in the same manner that is it was displaying earlier through the simple class component. But now this class component will have its own state, and this can be changed over the period of time, and as soon as it will be modified, it will be changed. This can be reflected through your application, and it will be easy to maintain between the states of the component. So that is why you need to use these state, right? This state is basically containing this containing the properties of the student component at a particular instance of time. So at this particular instance of time, this property says that the name of the student is Vikas. At some other point of time, it may be that the name of the student will change, the age of the student will change. Like as of now, my age is 39, but in the next year, but when I will move to the next year, it will be 40 years. So for that purpose, to display a particular state of a component on the web browser, we need to maintain the state for the components. Okay. So here we can see like how we can use it, and age is, you need to write like this dot state dot props, this dot state dot name, this dot props dot name. Other than this dot props dot name, you need to use this dot state dot name, and here you can use state dot age, years old. Okay, so now you can see the output: hi from student Vikas, and age is 35 years old. So whatever I have passed in the state, that has been maintained. Props, as I told you, that props contains whatever you have passed from here. So through that props, I have assigned the value of name and age properties to the name and age keys here in the state, inside this state. Okay, so this way you can manage the state of a component. Now if you are writing a constructor of your class, then you need to take care of two things, like inside the constructor, if you are writing this, then in that case, first you need to call the superclass with the same props. And then you need to maintain this state inside the class constructor, inside the class constructor. So here you cannot simply write a state, you need to write like this dot state, right? This dot state is equal to name and age, the same manner which I did earlier, the similar manner I have done here, but just you need to take care of this keyword. Whenever you are going to maintain the state inside a constructor, then you need to provide this keyword inside the constructor to maintain the state. Now if you will see this again, you will be able to see the same result, right? So I hope you have now understood that how you can use the state to maintain the state of a particular component inside the React component, which is based on a class. Okay, so we will meet in the next video. Till then, have a nice day and bye-bye.